Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining today. I am Preeti Srinivasan, VP of Product at DataStax. DataStax is the real-time data company for your generative AI application needs. AstraDB Vector is our vector database product, the only vector database that works in production for real-time GenAI capabilities. So today, you've joined me to learn how building generative AI apps got a lot faster and easier. We're gonna cover about some of the challenges that developers face when it comes to building generative AI applications, how AstraDB Vector solves those challenges. We're gonna dive deep into demo. You're going to see some of the new experiences that we have added. And then also, we're going to walk through some code, go over some integrations, and give you useful reference links and notebooks that you can try it out yourself. So let's get started. When it comes to building generative AI applications, right? Developers want to be focused on building the AI app in their AI journey. And you see that they have like many use cases that developers are racing to build generative AI applications. And its vector database is de facto when it comes to building generative AI apps, because they bring in the enterprise context for your data that with which you can build generative AI applications for your users, for your customers. Right. When it comes to building generative AI applications, developers want good performance, high accuracy of the results. They don't want to see their results like hallucinating and providing incorrect, or even worse, something sounding correct but actually incorrect. So they want good performance from their applications. Developers want to take their applications into production quickly. They don't want to deal with complexities. And there is the huge evolving generative AI ecosystem, whether it comes to using your large language models or your vector database or any data processing that you need to do. And they want to be quickly able to bring all these things together when they're building their generative AI application. And generative AI application building process, when it comes to that, they don't want to invest necessarily on very specialized teams and complex tools, because the field itself is fairly new and they want to be able to quickly build these applications, so that they want simplicity in what they are building, the tools that they're using, where, again, like I started with, they want to focus on the AI journey on building these applications and not on complexities of these tools and trying to understand how these tools work instead. So this is where AstraDB Vector comes in. So AstraDB Vector is for like every developer building and productizing generative AI applications which need context augmentation. So we already have a AstraDB Vector solution in production, and we are introducing a brand new experience that makes it very fast and easy for you to build generative AI applications. So what are the benefits, right? You can easily set up and try out AstraDB Vector. As a developer, you can focus on building your application, the business logic, and immediately demonstrate value to your stakeholders with the POC, saying like, hey, this is the generative AI app that we are building. You can easily integrate, leverage the GenAI ecosystem tools, build better performing applications with like, reduced hallucinations and with low latency and high throughput, and you build a great performing application. And this is all for, you can build production ready applications with AstraDB Vector, right? Fast, memory efficient, being discovered, concurrency when it comes to also like, your real-time data. So you can bring all of these benefits together for building your generative AI application. So let's dive a little bit deeper. What's going to be in this new experience and preview? So one, it's a brand new UI workflow throughout your app building journey, from connecting to the database to loading data, to exploring your data, both your vector and non-vector data. And you can improve relevance and explore your data with that. Native clients, whether it's like Python, JavaScript, TypeScript, Java clients, the language which you are familiar with and in a format with the idiomatic to that language so that you can focus on building your applications fast. And the generative AI integrations, whether it's like LangChain, Llama Index, Purcell, these tools that get you quickly build your applications at the same time, leveraging all the benefits of this ecosystem itself. APIs, the new APIs, which are like optimized for vector, and it's powerful, like document style interaction with your data, so that you don't have to have the burden of bespoke database modeling for your data. And the algorithms, like best-in-class algorithm for best-in-class performance, JVector is a vector search engine which is optimized for performance. It surpasses scale and speed when it comes to older methods like HNSW and so on, so that you can bring the production-ready quality for your generative AI applications. So, in what use cases will this help you? Whether you're building AI assistants, chatbots, agents, copilots, or proactive GenAI applications, which proactively take actions for your users, for your customers, you can use it in any of these and more. These applications might need retrieval augmented generation. So you might have heard this term before. If not, retrieval augmented generation is a design pattern through which you get the data that is context relevant based on your enterprise data, right? So based on the query that the user provides, you can query from the vector database that's relevant to that data, retrieve that, and send that to the large language model so that the large language model can provide a context specific for your enterprise data response for your users. Flare, which is a forward-looking active retrieval generation, is it's another extension of this technique where there'll be many questions and bringing in these answers together and so on, many queries and putting those things together. Whether you're doing prompt engineering and real-time retrieval, want to reduce hallucinations, AstraDB Vector is a solution for you. And you can solve this is just a few examples. You can build a lot more, whether it's in a document Q&A, whether it's personalization, where you want to create solutions and responses and use data that is specific for the user. And whether you're performing image search or video search, audio, and so on, that you can use this. So now let's get into a demo. So all you have to do is log into your astra.datastax.com. So in this case, I've already enabled this preview for this new experience. Just click up. You just have to enable preview there, and you can try out the new experience that way. So it's very straightforward for you to create database, to load data, to explore your data, and analyze metrics and so on. So create database is as simple as you give a database name, you tell the region, and you can just get started with your database. So I've already created one just to walk you through for this demo. And so once you have created your database, you want to load data into your database, right? And that's pretty easy and straightforward. You can easily pick up select file, whatever your data set is, and you can just simply load this data via this UI. This provides you kind of a preview of your data so that you can see how the things look. You provide a name for this collection. It auto-identifies the vector field, which has the vector and the dimensions and similarity metric. You might already know, but in case what a vector is, an embedding is basically a numerical representation, a mathematical representation of whether it's your text or audio or video and so on, so that it with that, you can use that in a vector database, store it and retrieve that information to do semantic lookups so that you can build context-specific applications. So here I already have an example for you with the data loaded. And as you can see here, right, you can explore your data further without any code, whether it's vector or non-vector data using this. So you can choose whether it's like the table format or JSON, whichever that works better for you. And you can perform vector searches easily by just by a click of a button. And in this case, we are using like a movie data set. And so we're performing a, you know, a vector search here, and it provides you the cosine similarity analysis. So cosine similarity gives you an indication of like how close your query vector is to the results and how relevant, how similar they are. The highest being value being like one. So this tells you the similarity at K, meaning whether the top result 1 or 3 or 10 or 100, and what those similarity scores look like. And as you can see here, it even provides you similarity score for each of these entries so that you can further perform metadata filtering, add more keys and values and filter things out, and so that you can build an application that is and design queries that is like right for your application. So so you can explore data with this, and then now you can see like the key metrics and overview of that. We are pretty much like in a real time here, where you see how the query performance, the latencies look like at different reads and writes and throughput and things and so on. So you saw here via the UI workflow on how easy it is to create, load, explore, and analyze your data. So now let's see how that looks like when it comes to code. It's very simple here to know that how you can connect your code to this database. All you need is the token and endpoint. You can generate the token here, and here's the endpoint. And with that, you can get started with your code. There are many reference examples here and quick starts for you to help you get started. Let's take a look at an example here. This is an example for you to I'm using Python here, the Python client, and you're gonna connect to the database, create a collection, load data, and perform vector search. All of that in just this little code. That's it. With that, it's as simple as that. So you initialize, you use the token which we just extracted, the endpoint, and you connect to the AstraDB database. And you can add data, you can add your, create your collection and you add it. Add it to your database. And then this is how you will add our data to it. Just a simple example here. Here we're using a movie review, and we have the review, we have dollar vector, which is the embedding, which I was referring to. And you can as simple as just insert these documents. That's it. And your query, it's based on the query which you're going to do the search, the lookup, right? You just provide the query to a vector find on that. You say the limit of whether it's 2 or 3 or with the value of K and what fields you want to see. And that's it. You do a vector find and you see the results. This in simple example that you saw here in Python, how easy it was for you to connect, create collection, add data, and do vector search. So that's an example with how it works with code. A third thing is about the integrations and things that I spoke to you about, right? When it comes to building your apps, you're going to leverage the GenAI ecosystem. So in this example, we're going to walk through with LangChain and how easy it is to use AstraDB Vector with LangChain and build your GenAI application. You can run this collab code yourself to try this out. I'll walk you through an example here. So via LangChain, you simply import AstraDB and all the embeddings that you want to use. Like, it can be like, the large language model here. So you're using like, OpenAI embeddings here. And you simply connect with the endpoint and token. And you have basically creating the OpenAI embeddings for this. So now you're going to load a small data set. In this example, we are using like a philosopher quote data set. And the data looks like this, basically. It has like the author, the court, and metadata information, things, and so on. So now you add documents to the vector store. So along with this, we have inserted like 450 documents here with about these quote entries with metadata into the vector store. So let's perform a simple approximate nearest neighbor search, right? So when I was talking to you about embeddings, right? So, and we spoke about similarity metric, like how similar the embedding is to others. So approximate nearest neighbors helps you to identify the ones that are similar to that. And so that's where you say like, the top three, the top five, and you retrieve those results. So in this example, so we are seeing like a similarity search. We are performing a similarity search on text, natural language text here on our life is what we make it to the philosophical court. And you say you want to see the top three results. And this provides you the top three results, which have like semantic similarity here, and provides you these results. So so you want to analyze more. You want to see what are the scores, what are the similarity scores, and you can get those similarity scores here as well, here, which is quite straightforward. You print the score here. So not just that, now you want to like further add metadata filtering. So you want only say, author here in Aristotle. Some of the way for you to equate this and see, right, in your data, it can be like, oh, only for a particular customer or only for a particular user, or you can filter things like, based off on that. And here, now these results are filtered with metadata that's specific for this author in this example. So you saw how easy it is to do make a natural language query, use LangChain, and use AstraDB vector to insert and retrieve data and perform a similarity search based off on that. So now let's look at a mini retrieval augmented generation example here. Okay, so we are using LangChain again, and you're using some of the capabilities that's already up. You can use via LangChain, like recursive character, text splitter, and things and so on, data loading and so on. You use this character text splitter so that you can create chunks of your data. So in this example, we are using this this PDF. And this is an example for you. So you can equate this to some sort of your document, your proprietary data, or where your business knowledge is and so on, right? And you can create chunks based off on that using text splitter so that to fit things under the context window for the large language model. So that's what you do here. You create chunks, and there's also a kind of overlap to make sure the continuity is there and the context is not lost. And you load this data, and you insert this data into the vector store. In this case, the vector store is AstraDB vector. So here we are using the recent like LangChain expression language. This is like very easy way for you to quickly prototype and for you to so that you can deploy your applications fast. So in this, this is where you come to the prompt engineering side of things, right? So like I was saying, retrieval augmented generation is for you to for the query, I didn't be able to query request that comes in, looking up the vector store for similar context there, augmenting that and sending it over to the large language model so that it can produce a human-like response with the context for your data, right? So this is where you're creating the prompt engineering template here, where you say like, hey, this is the kind of philosopher you want your large language model to be. The context is the data that you retrieve from your vector, and the question is the query that comes in from whether you're a user or customer or so on, and then the answer. And you simply chain all of these things together. The context, the question, you basically hear on a little pass-through, is like it goes unedited. You just get the question as is. what the prompt, you pass the prompt here, and then the large language model, and you basically parse the output and share the output. So you perform invocation with this like very specific question, and that information is like very context specific that's available here. And the large language model uses that context and provides you the with the answer that's specific to this context. So that's how you can do retrieval augmented generation for your data, for your enterprise data, so that you can provide relevant and context-specific results and build generative AI applications for that serves your users and customers. What did we just see? You saw how easy it was to set up and try out AstraDB Vector. You saw the entire UI workflow and how simply you can bring in the data, explore the data, and so on. Then you saw how easy it was to develop generative AI applications fast, whether you're using Python or JavaScript or TypeScript, or you easily connect with that and you can write your generative AI app in the language that can you're comfortable with, and you create the application with that. And then third, you saw seamless integration with generative AI ecosystem. In this example, we saw LangChain and how you can easily build your generative AI application leveraging all of this. So you can scan this QR code to get started. It's try this new experience yourself. You just log into astra.datastax.com, enable preview, and the examples which I shared here, here's the link for that. So you can try out these examples yourself. And I can't wait to see the amazing generative AI applications you're going to build with AstraDB Vector. Thank you.